In this screencast, we're going to work through a brief example on calculating the buoyant force acting on a ball, but specifically what we're really interested in is all these baseballs that get hit into the water from baseball parks, they float. And so what fraction of that baseball is submerged underwater? And if you want some extra credit work, what is the height of the baseball above the surface of that water? So when we think of the buoyant force acting on an object, we know that it's related in magnitude to the specific weight of the fluid times the volume of the fluid that's displaced. And so we don't necessarily know the volume that's displaced, and that's partly what we're trying to find. So based on this alone, we really have no information to work off of. This is where research comes in, and we should look up some things for our system. And so the typical baseball diameter is around 3 inches. Let's assume it's 3 inches. The weight of an average baseball is about 5 ounces. We know that the specific weight of our fluid, in this case water, is 62.4 pounds per foot cubed. So really at this point, we have everything we need to attack this problem. Since the ball is floating at the surface, it's not accelerating, it's not moving, we're at equilibrium. So we know that the buoyant force must be equal to the weight of the baseball. So this means now we set the weight of the baseball equal to the displaced volume due to the baseball that's submerged and the specific weight of the fluid. And we have some values for this. So 5 ounces is equal to 62.4 pounds per foot cubed. And then we could solve for the displaced volume. We need to convert these to the appropriate units. There are 16 ounces to a pound, which now means that the volume of our fluid that we displaced due to the submerged baseball is 5 times 10 to the minus 3 feet cubed. So how does this volume of our displaced fluid relate to the actual volume of our baseball? So the volume of a sphere is 4/3 pi r cubed, and we know our diameter is 3 inches. So if we plug in values and convert it so that we have it in feet, since this is reported in feet cubed, we can solve the volume of a baseball as 8.18 times 10 to the minus 3 feet cubed. So now we take the ratio of what's displaced over the actual volume, and we get 0.611, or 61.1% of our baseball that's submerged. Now we're going to figure out the height of the ball that's above the surface. So what we're looking for is this height h of the baseball that's above the surface of the water. And so there is a relationship we look up for the volume of the spherical cap, which is pi times h squared over 3 times 3r minus h. Now this r is the radius of our baseball, and h is the height above the surface of the water to the top of the sphere. Now we don't know the volume of this cap, but we do know the volume of the sphere, and we also know the volume that's submerged. So the difference between the two is going to give us the volume of the cap, and then we could plug in values into our equation and solve for h, and it should look like the following. Now it's a matter of simplification and solving for h, which I get as 0.106 feet, which is approximately 1.27 inches. So that is the height of the baseball above the surface of the water.